Hi, I'm Chanel Shea Calvin, and you're watching What's On. Now, in the second half of today's show, I'll be joined by one of our regular reviewers, Alan Musson, who'll be giving us details of this month's jazz events. And in the studio with me today is local musician and studio manager, Tom Peel. He's also one of the organisers of Boldmere Music Festival, which is taking place on the 20th of June. But before I welcome him to What's On, I'm going to hand you over to Lee and Gary for the rundown of this week's happenings.
Thanks, Chanel. Well, first we're going to Defy Gravity, and that's the name of an evening of songs from the shows, with musicals from the golden age of Rodgers and Hammerstein to the love ballads of Andrew Lloyd Webber and the modern musical theatre repertoire. You can hear songs from your favourite shows, such as Les Miserables, Chicago, Wicked, Sound of Music and My Fair Lady. And that's all at the Oaken Gates Theatre on Tuesday the 16th. Next up is Buffini's Silence, which takes place in the Dark Ages, in Britain being savaged by Viking attacks during the reign of King Ethelred the Unready. You can catch Silence at the Old Rep Theatre from Wednesday to Saturday. Next, we have At Ease, which follows a man imprisoned for the attempted murder of actor, politician and gay activist Michael Cashman. The Billings talk about pain and joy, tragedy and humour, which all combine to reveal both the darkest and the most beautiful places in humankind. At Ease is at the Old Jointstock Theatre from Wednesday to Saturday. Bit of music next, and Indigo is going to be at the Jam House, embracing soul and jazz with roots in gospel and reggae. The Manchester-born vocalist, songwriter and pianist Indigo is an exceptionally versatile singer, and that's at the Jam House on Tuesday night. And finally, Gilbert O'Sullivan was the superstar who topped the US and UK single charts in the 70s with songs of endearing tunefulness, unabashed sentiment and existentialist musings. Well, today he continues to be regarded with tremendous affection, and his songs remain well-loved around the world. Gilbert O'Sullivan is going to be at the new Alexandra Theatre on Thursday night. Well, that's your lot. Whatever you do, have a good week, and I'll see you soon.
Thanks, Lee. Well, in the world of tennis, the Aegon Classic returns to Edgbaston Priory Club in Birmingham this coming week, and the Lawn Tennis Association has announced that it's the strongest player field in the event's history. 10 of the top 20 women, including Simona Halep and defending champion Anna Ivanovic, it's easy for me to say, they're currently ranked inside the world's top 10 and they'll both be competing. Now, if you'd like tickets or more information, please go to the website. It's all the W's, edgbastonpriory.com.
There really is something for everyone. And if you want to have your event mentioned on the programme, the job's an email and the details are on the bottom of the screen. Well, welcome, Tom.
Hello, Chanel.
Thank you for joining me today. So before we go on to the event, which you're obviously one of the organisers of, just tell me a little bit about yourself and how you actually got into the music industry.
Sure. So I've been performing in Birmingham for about 10 years, playing kind of starting off with open mic and then going on to some bigger venues like the Hare and Hounds and King's Heath, Yardbird when it was open, those things. Mm-hmm. About a year ago, I decided to open my own studio.
Nice.
It's like a crowdfunding studio. So basically, if you don't have the money to record in a professional studio, you come to us and we put you through a crowdfunding process where your friends and family and kind of your fans can pledge for the CD when it's finished, or for a launch ticket, or for a house show or something. So you collect the money in a crowdfunding campaign, and then when you have that kind of bucket of money, you can go and record in the studios that we have.
So why did you want to like go into that then? I've
been a keen producer quite a while. I like to produce my own stuff and kind of learn the technology of it. I did a degree in music technology, and so after working for 5 years in a school, I decided to break away and go into doing something that I love.
Nice. So what is the music scene actually like in the Midlands? Is it quite difficult to establish yourself as an artist?
I think now is the best time to start gigging. There's loads going on in Birmingham. There's all sorts of new music nights and new events, different sort of events as well, like Digbeth Dining Club and kind of we do Folk in the Forest in the Samwell Valley, which is just an acoustic kind of session around a log fire in the bird reserve there. So there's lots of different things to do, and I think there's loads of opportunities at the moment. The last few years have been brilliant for Birmingham in kind of generating new artists.
So coming to the event, which obviously you're one of the organisers of, just what is that about and who can we expect to see in there?
Okay, so basically Boldmere Road is full of independent shops, and to kind of celebrate that independent kind of scene, they're having a music festival, and there'll be two stages. We'll be having Ruby and Ed, Faux Palms, which is Rick Welling's band. We'll be having Samuel J. Lawrence play, Marlon, Mike Maloney. I've got a list over here. Midnight Bonfires, who are kind of a big name in Birmingham. I'll be playing as well. And James Summerfield too. Yeah, quite a few guys. A lot of them feature on this, which is an acoustic compilation we did of 10 North Birmingham artists. And all the proceeds for that go to the Norman Lord Association. You can get that on bandcamp.com if you look for Northside Studios. Yeah, so there's going to be a broad spectrum of events. There's going to be about 17 different artists.
So look about that. Obviously, you're an artist yourself. You've been quite selfless with it. Obviously, giving people a chance to create their own music, putting on this festival. I think that is really nice. Do you think the Midlands like sort of needs things like this?
Absolutely, yeah. You can see it as selfish perhaps, but I see it very much as the value in networking with these people and the value of generating a base of kind of collective of people to support each other. And you go a lot further yourself as a group than just trying to strive on your own. And kind of, I find promoting myself really laborious and hard to do. And but to do it as a collective with a group of people and say, look, we've got this, this and this. I find it much more satisfying as well.
It's going to be quite a lot of fun as well, to be fair.
Absolutely.
Yeah. How did you like go about finding all of these artists? Are they all quite local?
Yeah. Apart from Samuel Lawrence, who's from Nottingham, he was one of my crowdfunded artists that late last year we crowdfunded his. Apart from him, everyone else is Birmingham based. And it comes from 10 years in Birmingham, basically, in the music scene. I've kind of got the network and I can now draw on these people. Now I've got a studio, now I'm doing events and things, and they're happy to help.
There's going to be like so much talent in the Midlands. I think people probably think, oh, is London the place to be? So I think it's nice that you're sourcing like the majority of local people in this event as
Yeah, and people I think are kind of coming out of London up to the Midlands more. I know Laura Hocking is one of the artists we've got playing. She's got a beautiful voice. She's come up from London to the Midlands, and as far as I'm aware, she's enjoying herself here and enjoys it compared to London.
So I'm right in saying that is it the first of this event that's happening?
That's right.
Exciting. So you're putting like a stamp on it.
Yeah, absolutely. And the idea of the studio, the Northside Studios, is to bridge the north of Birmingham with city centre, because there's so much music going on down south of Birmingham, which is fantastic. I love going Mosden, Kingsheath, but I'm just trying to cultivate something more for the north of Birmingham, so we don't have to go travel though so
far. Yeah, just because I have the north.
A couple of buses away, isn't it? But yeah, trying to do some more stuff, like at the Church Inn on Great Hampton Street, which is kind of edging its way in the Jewellery Quarter up to the north of Birmingham. Mm-hmm. Those guys that do a lot of events there, they're a fantastic business to work with.
So have you got any future plans for yourself or like for the festival at all?
There's murmurings of maybe doing a bigger festival in Sutton Park, which might be, which you know, could be really, really good. I'm releasing myself an album, hopefully October, November this year. I'm collaborating with 10 different Birmingham bands on 10 of my kind of older songs. I've tongue-in-cheek called it Tom Peel's Greatest Hits, but that was crowdfunded, and that's really good fun to work on, so that's kind of a release I'm doing as well.
So if people want to find out more information about yourself or the event, where can they go to check that out?
Yeah, sure, so there's northsidestudio.co.uk, or you can find tompeel.co.uk for my own music. The other thing I'm doing is a Birmingham studio tour in the summer. I'm getting a minibus and we're touring around all the different recording studios in Birmingham to kind of see what they're all about, and you can find a Facebook page, Birmingham Studio Tours, for that as well. It's going to be good fun.
That sounds really cool, to be fair.
I'm
not quite sure what studios are based in Birmingham, so I guess that will be a really good insight.
Yeah, and it's to try and generate, like, Birmingham has so many studios that people don't know about, and it's like there's a lot of recording going on, and it's want to develop a kind of a city of excellence for recording studios, which it already is, just needs to be made aware of.
And create a nice little buzz as well.
Yeah, absolutely.
So I just want to say thank you so much for joining
me. Thank you.
Now, just a reminder, the date of that event is the 20th of June. Now, coming up after the break, I'll be joined by Alan Musson, who'll be letting us know about the jazz events that are taking place in the region this month. Now, to play us out of this half, here is Tom Peel with Ring, Ring, Ring.
This is a song about telephone interference. All I want to hear is a ring, 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 a ring, 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 a ring, ring, ring. All I want to hear are my speakers to interfere with that and hear your sweet voice sail through my telephone, oscillating in a mid-range monotone. All I want to hear is that didn't do do didn't do do didn't do do didn't do. All I want to hear are my speakers to interfere with that and hear your sweet voice sail through my telephone, oscillating in a mid-range monotone. Who could have thought something so unrhythmical could make my heart pound? Who could have thought something so unrhythmical could make this love real?
Hi, and welcome back to What's On. Now, last week I had the band E of E on the show, and they have given us 6 CDs and T-shirts to give away. Now, to get your hands on any of these, all you need to do is email us at whatson@bigcentre.tv, put E of E in the subject line and tell us the name of the lead singer. Now, don't forget to include your contact details. And for one lucky winner, you'll be able to see the band perform at Lichfield Rocks on the 28th of June. You have until the 17th to enter, and the winners will be announced on the 22nd of June. So, good luck. So, welcome back, Alan.
Thanks. Thank it's good to coming. Be back again.
It's nice to have you back again.
These weeks fly by, don't they?
It really does. So, what is happening like this summer in relation to like jazz? Is there quite a lot happening usually?
Summertime coming on. There's festivals. There's one festival this month. There's 2 or 3 coming up in July. So, lots happening. Plus the regular residencies that go on week in, week out, all around the year.
Oh, nice. So, is summer quite prominent for it then? Or is it just a...
It is really, yeah. It used to be quiet in the summer years ago. You know, the jazz clubs had closed down about this time of the year and reopen in September, October. But now we've got the festivals to keep us all happy through the summer.
Oh, that's exciting. So have you got a list of what's
I've got a
place?
Few. I've got a few to mention later. But just to start with, the regular things. Tonight, if you get your skates on and get over to York's Bakery in New Hall Street, you can catch Percy Persglove and Andrew Bain. Mm-hmm. That's at 7:30. So you might just catch the second set there. Tomorrow, Ben Lee and his band, plus a jam session, are at the Spotted Dog, which is at Warwick Street in Digbeth, and that's from 9 o'clock. Over at the Jam House, there's Indigo, that's at St Paul's Square. And then moving on to Thursday, we've got a band, an anonymous band. It just says band plus support, plus a jam session.
So is he going to go there and see who this anonymous band is?
That's
quite
it.
Exciting
that's
to
part of the fun, isn't it? You don't know who you're going to be seeing. It might be somebody famous or not, but that's downstairs at the Fleet Street Kitchens, which is Summer Row in the centre of town. Mm-hmm. If you fancy some traditional jazz, you've got the Washboard Syncopators. They always have lovely names, don't they? Syncopators. And they're at Harrison's Sport and Social Club in Great Wyly.
What is classed as like traditional jazz sort of?
Old-fashioned pipe and slippers type, syncopated stuff, not the modern stuff, which I particularly prefer.
You prefer that one?
I do, really, yeah. Moving out towards Coventry, we've got a group called Standard Miles, which is a group led by the saxophonist Simon Spillett and the trumpeter Henry Lowther, and they're revisiting the Broadway song material of Miles Davis that he created in the 1960s. So that's something that I would enjoy. Mm-hmm. And that's at the Albany Club in Earlsdon Street, Coventry, 8 p.m. for that one. Out in the countryside in Tenbury Wells, we've got John Etheridge, a wonderful guitarist, and Remy Harris, an equally wonderful young guitarist. He's only about 24, 25 years of age, but there's nothing he can't play, from blues to gypsy jazz. And
so it's nice that they incorporate younger people as well as the more
right.
mature people as well.
Yeah, well, he's playing in his own front room with John Etheridge at the Hatch in Lindridge in Tenbury Wells. Booking's essential for that one, because mm-hmm. it's his front room, effectively.
That's a fair point.
And you can hear some of Remy under us now as we speak. So it'll give you a flavour of what you'll get if you go over there. On Friday the 19th, we've got the Young Pilgrims, plus a band called Autumn, at a new venue to me called The Sun at the Station, which is in High Street, King's Heath. Mm-hmm. And that's from 8 o'clock. Moving on to Saturday the 20th, Sax in the City with the Note Benders.
Sax in the So I just love the little point on that there.
Yeah, you wouldn't forget that, would you? They're at the Symphony Hall Cafe Bar from 1:30, and that's a free admission. On Sunday, Chris Young hosts a jam session at the Brown Lion in Hall Street in the Jewellery Quarter. And the Jewellery Quarter seems to be a bit of a hotbed for jazz. There's lots going on there at the moment. So somewhere to make your way to if you like your modern jazz. Back to the Jam House, we've got Three Step Maneuver. So the modern bands have funny names as well as the trad bands. They're on at 8:30. Back to the trad jazz in Solihull at the British Legion at 1 o'clock. We've got the Tierra Buena jazz band. So again, funny names. And then we're back down to Monday again, 22nd of June. Percy Purslove and Andrew Bain back at York's Bakery. It's a regular Monday night
section.
Oh, so
it's not as if they perform once, you can always see them again.
That's right. If you miss them tonight, there's a chance next Monday, and the Monday after, and the Monday after.
Oh, that's quite nice, that is. Does it usually play the same sort of music as well?
No, they generally have guests, different guests in, so it's a variety of music. So it's well worth popping along and seeing what's on. On Tuesday the 23rd, we've got Neon Villages, plus a jam session over at the Spotted Dog again, because that's a regular session on a Tuesday at the Spotted Dog.
Where's that
different
place
bands.
Again?
That's in Digbeth, so not far to get, really, and that's at 9 o'clock. Over in Stratford-on-Avon, at number 1 Shakespeare Street, appropriately named.
Very appropriate.
We've got a band called Stekpana and the Russians. I don't know them, but apparently they're very popular.
I know we keep on about the names, but they really like them.
I don't know how they come on. It probably means something in Russian, I suppose. Don't know. We're on safer ground with the trad jazz of Kevin Granville's Jazz Giants. They're over at the Sutton Jazz Club in Warmley Social Club. And then the first of the festivals from the 24th to the 28th of June, Lichfield Blues and Jazz Festival with Paul Jones and the Blues Band, which I'm sure everyone will have heard of, even if they're not specifically jazz fans, Jay Phelps, the Sleaze Brothers, and John Etheridge coming back again, we mentioned him earlier, with Remy Harris, with his organ trio this time, and he's also doing a guitar workshop. And you can hear John Etheridge under us at the moment too, so another great guitarist.
Nice.
And our own Steve Ajayo is also going to be doing some solo blues guitar, so that's Birmingham represented over there as well. Mm-hmm. Plus the very well-known Climax Blues Band. So they're playing at various venues throughout the Lichfield Festival. And Thursday the 25th of June, Nigel Beer and the Blue Notes at the Silver Shine Jazz Club for Bearwood Corks over in Bearwood. More trad with George Huxley's Jazz Band at Solihull British Legion. In Solihull, strangely.
Yeah.
Back over in Bilston, the Trevor Emony Quartet doing their regular once-a-month gig on the Thursday, the 25th. Friday the 26th, Romana Campbell's Quartet, which is a new name to me, at the Bacchus Bar, which also is a new name to me, which is at Burlington Arcade in New Street, so central Birmingham.
It's nice that new venues are actually joining in with obviously all these sort of events as well.
It's good.
Not just the same ones.
It's good, and we've got the Birmingham Jazz Festival coming up in the early part of July, and we tend to find new venues springing up to cater for the festival and then carrying on with jazz after the festival is finished as well. So it's another way of encouraging them. Swing Parade at the Trumpet in Bilston. Chris Young again on Sunday the 28th with his jam session at the Brown Lion in the Jewellery Quarter. The Steve King Big Band at the Laurels Cub in Cradley Heath. Percy Purslove again on the Monday the 29th. I said they'd be back.
So you can't miss them, you see them again.
That's right. Reg and Musty at the Trumpet in Bilston. Outward Jazz Quintet on the 30th of June at the Spotted Dog, and the splendidly named New Orleans Wanderers are wandering around Bourneville. More trad jazz on the 30th of June. Frank Sinatra Jr. is with an orchestra at Symphony Hall. And then on Monday the 6th of July, we've got Brian Newton's Big Band. He's been running a big band for 45 years, and they're at the Triplex Social Club in Eckersall Road. And then, no relation, Dave Newton. He was over in Cheltenham last month. He's at Worcester at the Found City Walls Hotel, again on the 6th of July. More big band music on the 10th of July with the BBC Big Band playing the Sounds of Cinema at Lichfield Garrick. And the Worcestershire Jazz Orchestra are at Droitwich British Legion, Salwat Robin Droitwich as well on the 10th of July. And a couple more festivals to mention. From the 10th to the 12th of July, the Mostly Jazz, Funk and Soul Weekender takes place in Moseley Park, and headlining that, Gregory Porter, and also featuring Roy Ayres, Craig Charles, Sugar Hill and many, many more.
Oh, nice.
And One that I'm particularly interested in, the JQ Jazz 15 Legends, which runs from the 17th to the 19th of July at the Red Lion Warstone Lane in the Jewellery Quarter, and other venues sponsored by JQ. And that's curated by the jazz trumpeter Henry Lowther. And a whole range of bands will be playing, and Henry will be guesting with some of them. And also double bass player Dave Green, who's been around the scene for years and years. He's going to be in residency there as well. Mm-hmm. And you can get more details by going to the Birmingham Jazz website, as they're running that. And finally, really, just to mention, the Birmingham International Jazz and Blues Festival will be upon us from the 3rd to the 12th of July, and we'll have a special feature on the festival in a couple of weeks' time.
Oh, that'd be really nice. As always, you've provided us with so much information on the jazz festivals and obviously events. I just want to say thank you so much again.
It's my pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That's all we've got time for today, so be sure to check us out on Twitter and also send us an email if you'd like to appear on the show. And to play us out, here's some Gregory Porter. I'll see you soon.
Hey, Laura, it's me. Sorry, but I had to ring your doorbell so late. But there's something bothering me. I really am sorry, but it just couldn't wait. Is there someone else instead of me? Go ahead and lie to me and I will believe. You're not in love with him and this fool can see that the rivers of your love flow uphill to me. Hey, Laura, it's me. Sorry, but I had to ring your doorbell so late. But there's something bothering me. I really am sorry.